Chat in Teams is a feature that you will use all the time. It is a good place to hold a private conversation about a topic that may not need to be discussed in a Teams channel in front of everyone. To get started, go to the left-hand navigation rail and select Chat. In the navigation pane, you will see a list of all of the chats that you have been a part of, including ones that were part of a Teams meeting. To create a new chat, go to the top of the navigation pane and select the New Chat option, and then start typing the name in the To field that appears in the content section. Navigate to the bottom of the screen and start typing in your message. Because we're in a chat, anything that you type here will be private between you and the person or persons on the To line. For now, we just have Nestor, so only Nestor is going to see this message. Notice the toolbar beneath the message window. This gives you the option to add in some formatting options, attach files, use emojis, even create forms. In this example, I'm going to use the attach option to provide Nestor a link to the SOP that I asked him about in the question above. The document is in the chat, but it can also be found in the Files tab at the top of the content section as well. As you start to have more chats, the most recent ones will filter to the top of the navigation pane. If you want to make sure a specific one stays at the top, you can select that message, go to the three dots, and then select Pin. And notice that my conversation with Adele is now at the top of the screen, and it will stay there until I unpin it. Adele just responded to my chat, and I do want to have a conversation with her, but I also want to keep working on another task in Teams. A great way to have both things going at the same time is to use the Popout Chat feature, but this is only available in the desktop app. It's not available in the web app. Notice that this created a separate window for my chat with Adele that I can move around as needed. Now let's talk about group chats. So far, I have just shown chats with one person only. If you select New Chat, you can start typing in multiple names. This will create a group chat, but here I want to give you a tip about an underused feature. If you click this little dropdown on the right-hand side of the screen, it's going to open up an option for you to rename the chat instead of leaving it at the default of all of the names of the group participants. I find this makes it easier for me to find the various chats that I'm participating in. Let's go back to the right-hand side of the screen and look at the View and Add Participants button. This is where you will go if you need to add or remove people to the chat. So here you can see the three people who are currently in the chat. I can add people, leave if I want to, or remove other members from the chat. Let's take a look at adding a person. This brings up a floating dialog box where all you have to do is type in the name or email address of the person you would like to add, and then decide how much of the chat history should be included. The default is don't include chat history. You can choose to include chat history for a certain number of days, or you can include all chat history. In this case, all chat history is appropriate, so then I will click on Add. Nestor has been added to the chat, and you can see a confirmation message that he has access to all chat history. A recent addition to the Teams chat feature is the option to create a chat with yourself. You will be the only one who could see the chat. I use it to collect links and important information that I need when I'm switching between my work and my personal computer. Teams chat is just one part of the application. There is so much more to learn. To learn more about Teams, check out the video on the screen, and I'll see you in the next video.